Hey, welcome to From Scratch Ranch. Jason here. What I'm doing right now is applying this anchor seal to the ends of these logs here. What this is a sealer to slow down the drying process to keep the logs from checking, cracking in the center here. It just slows that drying process down. So it's super important to do it towards, you know, the beginning when you first get these logs cut. So that's what I'm doing here. But I thought you also might be interested in how I got these logs here. That's what this video is about. Where did I get them and how did I get them here? These particular logs here came from a friend of mine's property where they the county widened the road there along his property and felled all of these oak trees onto his property. And he asked them if he can keep them. And they said yes. So he called me up and said, hey, I got a bunch of logs. You want to come pick them up? So I did. I went and picked these up. He kept all the limbs and the branches for firewood and then just burned the rest of it. But that's one way I've sourced these logs from friends that have had trees felled, and I've taken the straight sections of them if it's good quality wood. Another source is Facebook Marketplace, where I keep my eye out there for free wood and just check it out to see if it's close, check it out to see if they've got some good, you know, straight logs in there, and I'll go pick those up. And I use my tractor and my trailer to go do that because that's easier than trying to pick out these logs that I have available to me in my own land here. We have 40 acres of woods behind me, and there's plenty of trees that I can harvest that are already dead, standing, some down, that would be great. But I don't know how to get my tractor all the way down there just yet without having roads and trails put in. So it would be a lot more difficult to bring those logs up now than just going into town and picking these up. So that's what I did. That's the video I'm going to show you now. So watch that while I finish sealing these all up with that anchor seal too. We'll be right back. Okay, that's how I get all my saw logs home. I use the 18-foot utility trailer back there to get them back home, and then I use the RTV 1140 Kubota to drag them off that trailer. And this thing's a tank. So in four-wheel drive, no problem. Strap around the log, hook it to the back of the Kubota, and just pull forward, and they come right off. And then I roll them down the hill, get them out of the way, and now I just need to go back and get my tractor. So another trip back to the site where the logs were, bring that tractor home, and then I can start moving the logs in place, getting them stacked up, ready to go. And then I'm done. I'm ready to start sawing some logs. All right, now you know how I get all these logs back on the property all by myself with the equipment I have. I know there's probably a lot better ways to do this, different ways to do it out there, different equipment that people have, different methods, but this is how I was doing it. It's been working for me and I could do it by myself with the equipment I have. So hopefully you enjoyed this video. If you did, hit that like button and subscribe if you're not subscribed already. We got a lot of new content coming out soon, especially with our house bill. So make sure you hit that alert bell too so you're notified when we do post those videos. So until next time, keep living the dream.